Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied Linde's process of liquefaction of air, in which it was following Joule-Thomson effect. So now, based on that theory only, a new modified technique has been replaced the Linde's process, that is known as Linde's Claude process. So let us learn about it and what does it has the main advantage rather than that of the Linde's process. Let us know about that. So now we are talking about Linde Claude's process of liquefaction of air. So basically, this is the modified setup of the Linde's process that we have studied in the last lecture. So basically, Claude's modified the Linde's process of liquefaction of air and made it more efficient. How more efficient? Now we are going to talk about. So for that instance, the diagram would be almost the same as I have made earlier also. But the thing is, there would be small modification here. So what is that modification? Let us learn throughout this diagram. So this diagram consists a inlet. This is the inlet of air that it would pass. This will be the, I will name it as A. This B will be the pump. Again, more than 100 atmospheric of pressure, it will pull the air towards inside. Again, this is the coil C. This is the container D, where the water gets separated. And this is the container E, where that air is being allowed to do a special work, and again that has been passed through this flask, that is F, and I would name this as suppose G. So this is the overall setup that I have made. So let me go through that, what actually happens in the overall process of Linde's Claude process of liquefaction of air. So again, it will be the same thing. What will happen is through A, air will get compressed or air will enter inside with the pressure of more than 100 atmosphere. So 100 atmosphere is very large compared to 1 atmosphere, because the 1 atmosphere is the one that in which we are living, or that we could hold that kind of pressure. So talking about 100 times more, that is more than 100 atmosphere pressure, that means we are making the gas to get heated up, or we are energizing that particular air. So what will happen, that hot air will pass through this coil, and this coil will let the air to get cool. So this will not only because of the help of the coil, we have to also pass the H2O or ammonia that could absorb the heat of this coil that would have been heated because of the compressed air that has been entered here. So what will happen, suppose if there is a possibility of H2O molecules which are been present in the air, that would be, there will be the presence of H2O molecules. So what will happen is, this H2O molecules will try to condense first. So in this case, basically H2 will be there and H2 will be liquefied. But it is not necessary that all the gases will get liquefied, because the gases, they will be in a gaseous state only, because even though as we have learned in end-use isotherm, and we have did a graph on based on that also, so we have learned that yes, at high pressure also some gases deviate from the ideal gas, and yes, they stay in the gaseous state, and it would be very much difficult for us to compress that gas. So suppose there is a possibility that there would be gas which will move away from the ideal gas behavior, and they would be very incompressible basically, or it would require more force to get compressed for that gases. So again, these gases would come or enter here. So this is the main thing that has been modified. So this is the whole setup. I have named it as E. So what happens is, that air basically that with a particular internal energy, it will make this piston, this is a piston, so it will make this piston to move towards the right hand side, or it will make it to move. So what will happen is, the energy that possesses the gases, so that internal energy, that will allow it to work and to move this piston. So in that process, basically the energy is now being transformed to do work. So now the heat, basically the heat is been now been allowed to do the work. So rest of the thing is basically the cool air. So that cool air, what will happen is, the cool air will again enter here, and it will the same setup like of the Linde's process. So it will enter through this small hole. I have named this as G, but again the G is itself again a coil. So we are passing it again through a coil. So basically initially here also the gas was being passed through the coil and it was being liquefied. Again it was liquefied with H2O, and again the gas which was in a gaseous state basically, again we have tried to liquefy it there. But this liquefaction is not possible until it performs Joule-Thomson effect. So what will happen actually, this hot air, suppose if the air is hot in this case, so what will happen is it will enter in this flask, and this flask has very much less pressure compared to that of the 100 atmosphere pressure. So what will happen that according to Joule-Thomson effect, the gas will get cooled. And as we know that when the gas gets cooled, basically it tries to condense. So basically the gas will try to turn into a liquid. So in this case, there is a possibility that we could get liquid gas in this case. So liquid get deposited on the lower edge of this flask, and we could collect that also. But again, suppose there is a possibility that most of the gas won't get liquefied. So again, this will enter through this whole container that we have drawn initially, like in Linde's process, and again this will be pulled up by 100 atmospheric pressure, and this process will go on continuing until all the gas or all the air is been liquefied in this region. So the most advantage in this process is it is more efficient that we have learned. Why? Because in this case what we are doing is we are letting the gas to perform a work, and because of that the gas gets cooled, because most of the energy was being transformed in moving this piston. So this makes the gas to be get cooled, and what happens, and this overall process is basically turning into an adiabatic process. So what happens is basically the gas or the air would get cooled up in this region, and we could liquefy the particular air. So this was the modification of Linde's Claude's process of liquefaction of air. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly. So yes, share this video with friends and try to understand more and more. And yes, share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.